So I want to work from that place tonight, starting in Hebrews 8. Let's take a look at the man Christ Jesus. I love to focus like a laser beam the sermons on Jesus, so that when you leave, you can say, I saw him tonight, and his name was Jesus. Now this, Hebrews 8:1, is the main point of the things we are saying. Technically, I need to read the first seven chapters of Hebrews to you, because chapter 8, verse 1 says, here comes the main point of everything I've tried to say for seven chapters. But how many of you know we have time to read all seven, but most people would check out. So I'll leave it up to you to go home and read the first seven chapters, and we get a good summation. The Cliff Notes version of Hebrews 1 through 7 is found right here at the top of Hebrews 8. Here's the main point of everything we're saying. We have such a high priest who is seated at the right hand of the throne of the majesty in the heavens. Notice that. Are we New King James? Notice capital H, capital P. There's your first hint. We're not talking about a mere man, because high priest here is a man named Jesus who's sitting, not standing, sitting, because his work is finished. The priest never got to sit down. But our Jesus, the high priest, is sitting because there's nothing left for him to do in regards to taking care of your issues. The high priest was always on his feet because every time he turned around, there was another guy coming in with a lamb. So he had to go back out front, do it all over again. About the moment he got his hands cleaned off at the brazen laver, he turned around, boom, there was somebody else needing to kill a lamb. He never got finished. He never got to sit down. It's why God didn't put a chair in the tabernacle. Go back and look at the furniture in the Old Testament tabernacle, and he didn't put a chair anywhere except the Holy of Holies, where the mercy seat sat. God sat there, but man was always at work. So when Jesus becomes high priest, he sits at the right hand of the throne of the majesty in the heavens because he's finished with the work. He's a minister of the sanctuary, verse 2, and of the true tabernacle which the Lord erected and not man. I want to stop here for a moment. I want to ask you a question. I'm not going to spend too much time on it yet because we're going to come back to it in a moment. If Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father and the majesties in the heavens, and that's the true tabernacle, where is the true tabernacle? Is the true tabernacle on earth, or is the true tabernacle in heaven? Well, if Jesus is in the heavenly, sitting at the right hand of the Father, then the true tabernacle is wherever heaven is. We're going to leave that right there for a moment, okay? Wherever heaven is, that's where the true tabernacle is. That tabernacle, the Lord built it, man didn't build it. 3, for every high priest, little h, little p, because now we're dealing with men. We're not dealing with the man, Jesus. We're dealing with men, Jewish priests. You and I aren't Jews. Our name's not at the top of this letter. We're not Hebrews. But we're writing to Jewish believers circa first century. People who come from Judaism into Christ, who've been dragging Judaism with them. And they've been going to temple their whole lives. And they've been killing lambs their whole lives. And all they know is Moses. And all they know are priests. And the author of Hebrews is trying to establish Jesus as your better priest. And your better priest is sitting down, and he's invisible, and he's in a place called the heavenlies. But every high priest on this earth is appointed to offer both gifts and sacrifices. In other words, they're offering up when people come to bring a gift to God, they offer it. When people come to make a sacrifice to God, they offer it. Therefore, it's necessary that this one, capital O, that's this Jesus, needs to have something to offer. If Jesus is really a high priest, then he needs to be able to offer something, because that's what priests do. Verse 4. For if he were on earth, he would not be a priest, since there are priests who offer the gifts according to the law, who serve the copy and shadow of heavenly things, as Moses was divinely instructed when he was about to make the tabernacle. For he said, see that you make everything according to the pattern shown to you on the mountain. And so now we've had the entire tabernacle system laid out in front of us via Moses, the giver of the law. Now watch verse 6. Here's your transition, the word but, a conjunction that shows us that something has changed. But now, he, capital H, now we're back to the high priest, now we're back to Jesus. But Jesus has obtained a more excellent ministry, inasmuch as he is also mediator of a better covenant, which was established on what? Better promises. Hebrews chapter 8 gives you this assurance. Jesus is better than any high priest you've ever known. This falls on deaf ears in the American church because we don't know high priests. We don't have priests in our church. In Protestant churches, evangelical churches, we don't know anything about it. And yet we still have hierarchy systems and pastors and leaders and people who we think are closer to God than us and people who we expect more out of than we think expected out of us. We still have our own sort of system, but here comes Jesus, greater than that system, greater than all of those people, greater than the ministry, greater than those titles. But what makes him greater? This text says nothing about virgin birth. It says nothing about healing the sick. It says nothing about walking on the water or never sinning. Now, all of those things are awesome and they're great attributes of who Jesus is. But according to this text, what makes Jesus a better high priest is not that he could feed the thousands, not that his mama didn't have sex with his daddy. That's what made him born of the virgin. Not all of the theological stuff. What made him a better high priest is he has better equipment. He has a better covenant built on better promises. What Jesus came to offer is superior to everything everybody at the top of the page had ever known. What am I talking about at the top of the page? What book are we in? Hebrews. Everything a Jewish person had ever known, Jesus comes and he's better. I got a better covenant. I got better promises.